Hey artists, welcome to the new school year. I am Seer, rhymes with the animal deer. I am your art teacher. We're gonna go on a quick tour of the art class and then we are gonna go ahead and get started with art today. So this is your art studio and we are gonna go over just a couple quick things. Now you're gonna be learning a lot of our routines from project to project, so we won't do too much right now. The first stop is our table baskets. So in our table baskets, you're gonna notice one cup of pencils and Sharpies and scissors and erasers. We want our little table baskets to stay looking like this at all times. And if you forget what your little handy dandy basket is supposed to look like, you can look right up at this poster. And this is what a happy table basket looks like. When we clean up, I'm gonna actually ring a bell this year. And the first thing you are gonna do is you are gonna clean up your artwork. Then you're gonna take care of your materials and your table, making sure everything is clean, and then you are gonna return to your seat and be silent and seated. What if you forget that? You can look right up here. Here we have table leaders. I will be choosing a table leader, and we're gonna change those table leaders once every 9 weeks. Now, table leaders, you are our materials managers, so I'll be asking you to get out materials. You are also our eraser protectors. It's a very important job. I'll go over what that means in a minute. And then you are a happy basket maker. So that just means that you make sure the baskets stay looking like that by the end of class. This is our Help Wanted board, and I will let you know the days that it's okay to go ahead and get a job. Some days we will get jobs and some days we won't need jobs. Now when you're done with the project, this is your area that you can kind of come find some things to do. So it's a little bit different location this year. We have all of our books right here. We have our scrap paper bin. Sketchbooks and art folders. This is a big one because they do actually count in your grade. And if you're tearing all your pages out, then I don't have anything to give you credit for. So please do not tear your pages out and fill up your pages. Use your empty space. You can color, you can add details. The paper that we get today should last you all year long. Our recycled paper bin is going to be up in our front hallway this year. So this bin is our no-name bin. It's also our misplaced art, and it's also gonna be our forgotten folder bin this year. Look at it right now, it is empty. I want it to stay empty. Of course, is our drying rack, and so you'll be visiting here a lot of times at the end of class, and I'll always designate a color on which you will put your artwork. Right here, we have some of our supply shelves, glue on the bottom, and we have our crayons right here, and we have our color pencils right here. And of course, we have our handy dandy little hand crank sharpeners. Those are just for our color pencils artists. Now, very important, for the cups of crayons and color pencils, each table only gets one cup. Please do not grab more than one cup, because then another table will not have a cup. I love erasers, guys, and the white erasers that we have are awesome. For some reason, artists are just so tempted to cut the erasers, stab them, poke them, tear them apart, chew them up. Do not do that. Table leaders, like I said, you are our eraser protectors, so I'm gonna count on you to kind of keep an eye on the erasers at your tables and make sure that everybody's treating those kindly. Now, sometimes we all need just kind of a little chill out time. Maybe we're just having a hard time at our seat. So this is an area where we might come, or I might send you to do a little bit of quiet solo work or side-by-side work. You'll also notice a change this year. Our first three tables are separated just like last year, but our back tables are actually pushed together. Now, the table numbers are still gonna be the same. So this little table right here is table number 4, and that's table number 5. So even the tables that are pushed together are still separate table numbers, and you will see your table number on your basket. Something else that's a little bit different this year is our soap. It is moved from the side to the front, and it's actually a lot better because we won't kick those anymore. Our paper towels will remain right there, and of course, as you remember, I'm a stickler about paper towels, so only one paper towel to wipe your hands. If you do not do that, I will put you on wipe down duty, so we do not waste paper towels. Over here, we have our paint brushes. We do a lot of painting in here, a lot of mixed media, and so these are well-loved tools. And here's a handy dandy little picture of what we want to try to make the paintbrushes look like at the end of classes. Over here, when I say the red wire rack, this is what I'm talking about. It's our red wire rack of our little palette paints. And then right here, we have our mixing palettes and then our extra little circles of our dry temper cake paints. Now, artists, I have high expectations for behavior and art because I feel like it's very hard to learn and discover and use your imagination and create when there's a ton of noise going on. The first 10 minutes of every art class, we are gonna actually work without talking. That just kind of gets us in the mode of creating. Now, our ART on the board is kind of our little noise control check. If the class gets too loud or if we're talking during that first 10 minutes, I will erase a T and that's your warning. If we start losing more letters, then we'll increase our silence time, which is never fun. Now, as far as positives and negatives for individual artists in here, every class we are going to have a star artist. Yay! That means you're gonna get a little punch in your name tag and you're gonna get one of these little forms to take home. Now, if I'm having to talk to you over and over about certain behaviors, and especially from class to class, then I might send one of these home. If you do get one of these home, this comes back the following day with your signature as well as your parent's signature, or it will be a phone call home. But I do not think we're going to have to use these because I think we're going to have awesome self-control in here. The biggest thing to remember as far as rules in the art fashion go is just respect. If you're respecting your teacher, yourself, and your classmates, as well as the materials in here, we're gonna be awesome. Thanks for watching, guys.